Hi everyone.
Hi. What dance form inspired you to dance?
I think I've always watched a lot of senior students in the school performing different sorts of Indian dances, including Bharatanatyam, which is probably one of the most famous Indian classical dances, just in terms of the number of people who do it. So I think looking at some of my seniors, I got really inspired. And especially just the attire and the beauty that comes through it, that inspired me a lot and made me want to dance.
What about you? Yeah, for me, because I was raised in India, so I had an exposure to a lot of Indian dances, classical dances as well. And all dances, including the dances in the Bollywood as well, you know, where they used to copy the classical dances, the Bharatanatyam dances or the Kathak dances, that really inspired me. The way they could really convey a lot of things without saying a word, that really gives me a lot of inspiration. So that's where
What makes you keep going on?
Once I discovered that, you know, dancing such a thing exists and you can express a lot without even talking, that kept me going. So dancing is my passion, be it any form. I just need to get into that. And yes, if you know a little bit about music, and especially Indian music coming from that background, it really helps. So yeah, Indian dances, I'm more attracted towards the Indian dances, although I really love fusing different dance forms together, and that way kind of broadens my my stage that way.
I think dancing for me, it's something that keeps me sane, something I look forward to every day. It's work pressures, whatever, family related issues or whatever it is. At the end of the day, if I know that I'm going to go and dance, I that automatically makes me happy. So it's kind of an integral part of my life. And so I think no matter what happens, no matter how busy I get, dance is going to be a big part of my life pretty much forever. And like her, it's not limited to Indian dancing. Indian dancing is definitely holds a special place in my heart. But I think I generally love the concept of dancing and expressing through dance. I think it's just another language that you speak.
Very true, very true. And I think the last point that we wanted to talk about was what do you want to achieve by dancing? Well, it's not about what I want to achieve. I always achieve that. It's the inner peace and the inner happiness. Somehow I just feel happy after I dance. So even if I'm in a very bad mood, very frustrated, just find a quiet room, not a corner room, where you can just, you know, vent out that frustrating energy, take it out in the form of dance, and you just convey to God, you know, I'm angry, do something about it. And yes, I feel good. So for me, that's a way of devotion, expressing my devotion.
Very cool. I think for me, I never thought about what I wanted to achieve initially. I think I just went into it. But it helped me do a lot of things over the time. One, I think it made me more confident, which I never was before. Obviously, it's a good exercise. Obviously, it keeps me sane. So those are a lot of things. So it made me more emotional as well. I think when you start thinking about the stories that lie behind all these dances, it makes you a little bit more of an emotional person. And then at this stage, after having danced for so many years, if I really think about what I want to do with my dancing, I think I want to spread the culture. Even when possible, I want to start teaching and passing on what I've learned. So that's sort of what I want to do through my dancing.
Yeah, that's actually great. Yeah, we should share what we have.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.